The answer is correct, but the way I did it was wrong. I have to use L'Hopital's rule to solve it. How should I solve it? Okay, let's have a look. Here we have the limit as x approaching 0 plus of x to the tangent x power. First, we put 0 into all the x's. In that case, we get 0, and then tangent of 0, well, tangent of 0 is 0. So this right here looks like we have 0 to the 0's power. Well, this is the common mistake that a lot of people just conclude that this is going to give us 1. In this particular case, the final answer is indeed equal to 1, but this right here is not the way to show it. Because we are working with a limit, sometimes when we get 0 to the 0, this right here is called an indeterminate form, it's on my t-shirt here. That means we don't know what the answer yet unless we do more work. Because sometimes, if we get 0 to the 0's power in a limit, we may end up with 0, or maybe we may end up with e. So we have different possibilities. And if you don't trust me, I will have those two videos in the description, you can check that out. We are going to really do it legitimately. But how though? Notice that the base right here is a function x. The power here is also a function tangent x. We don't like to have base x when we have the power being a function already. We like to have base e. So this is what we can do. Let's focus on the x. We are going to rewrite the x as e because we really like to have e, and then raise to the ln x power. Because e and ln cancel each other, so we can still get the x back. And then this is raised to the tangent x power. Now we can just multiply the powers together. So we have e and then ln x times tangent x. Now, when we're taking a limit like this, e to this power, we can just focus on taking the limit of the power and then at the end, just do e to that result. And we can do so because e to the x is a continuous function. So what we are going to do is put down the e and then focus on taking the limit and then just this right here. But right here, we are still running into a small trouble because if we put 0 plus into ln, what's ln of 0 plus? This means we are trying to take the limit of natural log as x approaching from the right hand side. Let's take a look at the picture. Here is the natural log graph. If we go from the right hand side, you see that the function will go straight down. So this right here will give us negative infinity. And then if we put 0 into tangent x, well, tangent 0 will give us 0. So we have negative infinity times 0. Guess what? We still cannot draw any conclusion yet because that's one of the indeterminate forms on the shirt. We have a total of 7 indeterminate forms. They're all here. So what do we do? L'Hopital's rule. But how? Remember, for L'Hopital's rule, we must have either 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity. One of these. So we have to somehow turn one of them to the denominator so that we get either one of these. I'm going to bring the tangent x down to the bottom and make that cotangent x, and that will work pretty good well. So let's see, e limit x approaching 0 plus. I will keep the natural log of x on the top, bring this down to the bottom, becomes cotangent x. If we have 0 plus into cotangent, let me just mention this real quick. You can focus on the graph again. It's going to give you something like this, right? So cotangent 0 plus, it will give you positive infinity. So have a look. When we put 0 plus into ln, we get negative infinity per our discussion earlier. On the bottom, we get positive infinity. So we can use L'Hopital's rule. Here we go. Because now we have infinity over infinity. Yes, we have a negative sign, but doesn't matter. It's a negative 1 times infinity. This is why it matters. So we can use L'Hopital's rule. Here we are going to look at this and take the derivative of it. Look at this and take the derivative of it. So e to the limit as x approaching 0 plus the derivative of ln x. Aha, we have to know our derivatives. And remember it really well, it's 1 over x. Now what's the derivative of cotangent x? Negative cosecant squared, yes. Then, if we plug in 0 into all the x's, let me tell you, we'll still get into trouble. But don't worry, because we can fix this a little bit. I'm going to just keep this as how it is. But I'm going to bring the cosecant squared up and make that into a sine squared. So right here we have 1 over x. Over this negative, it's just like a negative 1. I can put it on the outside of the limit. Right, so this negative is right here. And then cosecant squared up is the sine squared x. And this means sine x times sine x. And this is what I'm going to do. Have a look. E, and then this negative, limit x approaching 0 plus sine x over x. And then multiply by sine x. Just like that. Now, why am I doing this? Well, because this way, this is a standard result. And technically, what you have to do is, when you take the limit of this times that, it's the limit of this times the limit as x approaching 0 plus of sine x. The limit of a product, it's the product of the limit, so we can just focus on this limit and then focus on this limit. This right here is a standard result that it's equal to 1. Okay? The limit as x approaching 0 or 0 plus sine x over x, you will get 1. And then this right here, you can just plug in 0 in here. Sine is a continuous function. So this will give you sine 0, which will just give you 0. So all in all, we have e to the negative 1 times 0, which is of course e to the 0's power, and there you have it. This is the one that we have been looking for. So hopefully this right here helps, and again, go ahead and check out the videos where you have 0 to the 0's power, but you end up with 0, and you may end up with like other numbers such as e. And if you're interested in this shirt, the link is in the description as well. That's it.